Hello students, welcome to computer class. Today we will do the chapter number 4 of your computer book. The name of the chapter is Editing Text in LibreOffice Writer. Before we start the chapter, let us see what is LibreOffice Writer. LibreOffice Writer is a word processor component of LibreOffice. Now, LibreOffice Writer is a word processor component, means whatever you type, you can edit it, you can modify it, you can make the changes in that text in LibreOffice Writer. And LibreOffice Writer is the part of LibreOffice. Writer has a powerful and flexibility too. Now, Writer has some flexible features. Now, first feature is produce letters, reports, notices, newsletters, etc. quickly and in presentable manner. In LibreOffice Writer, you can make letters, reports, notices, newsletters very quickly and in a very presentable manner, in a very attractive manner. Next is modify the text both while typing and after typing. Beautify the text using colors, style, font size, border, shading and various other effects. Now in LibreOffice Writer, you can change the color of the text, style of the text, font size, border, shading, various other effects you can do in the text. And you can edit your text, make changes in the text during the typing or after the typing. Next is insert graphics and make use of various drawing tools to pictures. Copy and move the text from one location to another. Now you can insert any picture, any graphics in the text in your drawing and also use the drawing tools in the document. You can copy the text and move the text from one place to another. Preview the text before printing it and take multiple printouts. Now when you have typed the text, your document is ready. You can see the preview of the text document and then you can take the multiple printouts of this document. So all these things you can do very easily in LibreOffice Writer. Now we will learn how to start LibreOffice Writer, how to enter, select and edit the text in LibreOffice Writer, how to delete the text, how to undo and redo text, how to check the spelling and grammar, how to use the thesaurus tool in LibreOffice Writer. Now students, we will learn about starting LibreOffice Writer. How do we start LibreOffice Writer? To start LibreOffice Writer, as you can see the desktop, here in the launcher bar, there is LibreOffice Writer, right? Click on it and the LibreOffice Writer is open. This is LibreOffice Writer screen. Now here, this first bar where file, edit, view, insert, format is written, it is menu bar. And see here, this blinking line, this is cursor. And this white page is document area. And here at last, this bar is status bar. Here they have mentioned page number 1, number of words, if you have written, number of characters, default style, the language, okay? Now we will learn how to create a new file in LibreOffice Writer. Now to create a new file, new document in LibreOffice Writer, you will first click on File option from the menu bar. Then click on new option and then click on text document. Now see, the new file is open. Okay. Second method is, this is new button. If you click here, you can open a new file. This is the shortcut key, shortcut option. Now we will learn how to save a file in LibreOffice Writer, saving a file. Now see, this is our file. We want to save it. What we will do, click on file option from the menu bar. Then click on save. Now we want to save our file on desktop. So click here, desktop. Then here is the file name. We will erase it, the untitled one. And we will write our own name or anything else. Okay, return. Then we will click on save option. Now see here, on the desktop, the file is here on the desktop. Okay, this way we can save the file. Next is closing the file. If you want to close your file, if you want to close your file without saving, then you will click on close option from the file menu. Otherwise, you can save it and then you can exit LibreOffice. Right? This way you can exit from LibreOffice Writer. If you have already saved a file on the desktop, we can open it. How? Now see, this is our new file. Now we want to open a file which is already saved on the desktop. So click on file, then click on open, then from the desktop there is a file which we have saved. Double click it and it is open. Right? This way you can open the file. Next is printing a file. For example, we want to take a printout of this file. What we will do, we will go on file option from the menu bar, then click on print option. Before taking a printout, we can see the page preview, how the page will look when we will take the final printout. So if we are satisfied, we can click on printout option. File, print. Now we will learn how to select the text. Now see, we have typed this, right? Now if we want to select a word, we will double click. If we double click the mouse button, the word is selected. If we want to select a full sentence, we will triple click. Three times I have clicked and the sentence is selected. If we want to select a full paragraph, four times we will click the mouse button. Four times I have clicked and the full paragraph is selected. And if we want to select the whole paragraph, with one hand you will click on shift and then you will click on last character of the document. Okay. And last method is, just click on the first word of the document and drag it to the last.
double click, start dragging and come at last. Okay, this way you can select the whole text like this. Next is inserting the text. How we can insert the text? Now see, we have typed a document and after this line I want to add something. So what I'll do, I'll take my cursor here and then I'll write whatever I want to write. Okay, so I have added a word here. This way you can insert a word or a line in a document. Next is moving text from the document. We can move the text, typed text, from one place to another. For example, I want to shift first line in the last paragraph. I have selected it. Then you can cut it. Okay, for cutting the text there is a shortcut, Control X. Okay, with one finger you can click on Control and with other finger you can click on X. Control X. This way you can cut this text. Control X. Now the text is deleted from the previous place and now here I want to paste it. And the shortcut key of pasting the text is Control V. Same way, with one finger you will click on Control and with other finger you will click on V. Control V. Now see, I have pasted the text. Okay. And if you want to paste the same text at last but don't want to delete that text from the previous place, what you will do, again I will select a line, first line is selected. Now I will copy it, Control C, side by side, note down in the notebook or book, Control X cut, Control C copy, Control V paste. Okay, remember these three shortcut keys. Now I will click on Control C. Now it is copied, but see, it is not deleted from here, right? Now I will paste this line after this line at the bottom here. Now I will click on Control V, pasted, right? And if you are not able to, you are not comfortable with the shortcut keys, what you can do, select the text and here are the keys, Control X cut for cutting the text, Control C for copying the text, and this is paste for pasting the text. These keys you can use. Just select the text, cut it, click here and cut it, select the text, click here and copy, and go to the place where you want to paste and click on paste button and you can paste it. Next is deleting the text from the typed document. Now if you want to delete something from the text document which you have typed, what you will do, you will use two keys. First is backspace key, okay, and second is delete key. Backspace key and delete key. Now see, now I will show you the difference how these two keys works differently. Now see, if I want to delete this processing, right, backspace key from the back. Backspace key deletes the text from the back. And if I click on delete, it will delete from the front. Now next option is undo and redo text. Now this is our document. Now I have, this is my document first stage, okay. So now I am deleting this document, okay. Now I want document again, the word document again. What I'll do, I'll click the shortcut key of undo. The shortcut key of undo is Control Z. I'll click on Control with one finger and Z with other finger, okay. Document is again there, right? Now again I don't want this change. I want to go on previous stage, means I don't want the document. For that, what I'll do, I'll use the redo option. I'll use the shortcut key of redo. The shortcut key of redo is Control Y. I will click with my one finger Control, and with my one finger I'll use Y, Control Y. Again, document is not there. This way we use the undo and redo option. And if you are not comfortable with the shortcut keys, you can use the options given in the standard toolbar. Now here in the standard toolbar you can see undo, and if we want to use the option redo, it will delete document, okay. These two options are undo and redo options. You can use these options if you don't want to use the shortcut keys. Now next we will learn how to check spelling and grammar from the text we have typed. Now see here this cursor. Now I have written here the wrong spellings of cursor, right? So to correct it, what I'll do, I'll click here with mouse button and then I'll right click the mouse button and see, they will provide you the options which you can choose. Now the correct spellings of cursor are this, cursor, okay. We will click here. Now see, this way we can correct the spellings of the words, okay. The shortcut key of checking your grammar and spellings, it is F7. As you can see on the keyboard, this key, F7 key, you can click and you can see the grammar and spelling check option. Now I'm going to click F7 key. See, this is the dialog box of spelling and grammar check, okay. Now here it is showing Libre is a wrong word, okay. But now we know that it is correct word, but it is not in the computer dictionary. So sometime it happens. Click ignore it or click ignore all, means Libre word we are using so many times in our text, right? So click ignore all. Then here, why it is showing red line? Because document full stop Libre we have written, we have not given the space here. See, suggestions means the line should be like this, right? So if you want to correct it, you can click correct all, because same mistake is many times in the document. So you will click on correct all, so it will correct whole document where we have done this kind of mistake. So this way we can correct it. Now see, when we have selected correct all, our document is without red line, right? Now next we will learn how to use thesaurus. Now what is thesaurus? Thesaurus option gives us the synonyms of the given word. Okay. Now what is synonyms? Synonyms are the similar words which we can use at the place of some word. Okay.
Now see how to do the how to use the thesaurus option of LibreOffice Writer. As we know that thesaurus option helps us to improve our vocabulary by providing the list of synonyms, similar meaning words and related terms. You can select that word and change that word with the synonym of that word. Now how to do it? First you will select the word whose replacement or whose synonym you want to search, right? Then you will go on tool menu from the menu bar and then you will click on language, then thesaurus. Okay, and then in thesaurus dialog box you will get the alternative words of that particular word which you have selected, and this thesaurus will use English USA dictionary. Okay, according to English USA dictionary you will get the synonyms of that particular word. For example, we have used the word big. It will show different words for big: large, huge, right? Now let us see what we have read in this chapter. First, Writer application opens a blank document with temporary name untitled 1. If you have not saved the Writer document, it will give it a temporary name. The name will be untitled 1. Or if you have used this untitled 1 name once, then next time it will use untitled 2, then untitled 3. Okay. Next is making changes in document is called editing. If you change something in the document, that change is called editing of the text. Next is before performing any action like copying, moving, finding, replacing, deleting, formatting the text, you need to select the text first. Okay. Misspelled words are indicated with a red wavy line beneath them. Grammatical errors are indicated with the green wavy line. Thesaurus helps to improve our vocabulary by providing a list of synonyms or related terms. So these all things we have read in this chapter.